So we're here with Professor Aswath Damodaran, professor of finance at NYU Stern. The social media space, it looks as if Facebook is sort of running away with the game. You could describe the sector as Facebook and the Seven Dwarves. Every day they get stronger, they've made some incredible acquisitions. What does that mean for valuations in the space? Or as Facebook becomes more and more powerful, does the rising tide lift all boats? Or do we start to see the other ones deflate and Facebook continue to melt upwards?
I think the social media space is driven by this big online advertising market. So let's start with that as a premise. It's a big market, it's out there. And I have a feeling it's a winner-take-all market. It's a market where the winners, maybe not one, maybe two or three companies are essentially going to end up dominating that market. When Facebook first went public, I valued it as a Google wannabe, a company that if it was like Google would be a success. And I have to make a confession. I think Facebook has surprised me in really good ways. It's a company that seems to think about how to convert its users into revenues and profits every minute of the day. Yeah. It's not something I say about most of these social media companies because they seem to assume that if you have the users, the revenues will come. Mm-hmm. But Facebook, I think, has clearly kind of made that connection. And because of that, when I value Facebook today, I no longer value it as a Google wannabe. I think Facebook is going to dominate this business and Google is going to be the Facebook wannabe in this market. So I think if Facebook succeeds in the scale that it will, it's really bad news for a lot of the other social media companies in the space because there isn't enough of a market for them to survive. I think that if you're a social media company, then you got to think about niche markets. Mm-hmm. I think about LinkedIn, right? Mm-hmm. You go for a space where Facebook is not that interested and you make it your market. So I think increasingly from a business standpoint as a social media company, the domination of Facebook has to be built into your plans when you think about what to do next.
So let's talk a little bit about Facebook versus Google, because people talked about YouTube disrupting TV, and now it looks like Facebook might be disrupting YouTube. Right. And now there's more native videos being uploaded to the Facebook platform than links to YouTube. It looks like with autoplay, more video is going to be consumed off of Facebook than off of YouTube. Do you think you could potentially see an environment where Google starts to leak value and market cap to Facebook? Has it already started?
I think it's already started. And I think that for Facebook, the point at which that shift happened is when they succeeded on mobile. Because the reality is the future of this is all going to be mobile. I mean, we're not going to be sitting in front of laptops and computers checking out YouTube videos. You're doing it on phones and iPads. And the minute Facebook cracked the code, and it took them a while to do that, to get on mobile and get people checking Facebook videos on mobile sites, I think they were able to get a step ahead of Google. Because the reality is people no longer go through search engines looking for YouTubes. They go through Facebook pages looking for videos.
What do you think of this idea? And this is a question pregnant with a comment. We believe here that the Facebook native stories idea, where these old media companies are letting stories stay on the Facebook platform and then keeping the advertising revenue, we feel this is almost sort of a second self-inflicted wound, the first being the letting Google crawl their data and slice it up. But now they're saying, you can keep the advertising revenue, but we don't want people to leave Facebook. Doesn't that, at the end of the day, sort of lead these guys down the same path and ultimately spell even lower valuations for the old media guys, the New York Times companies, et cetera?
And I'm reminded of the old music companies telling Apple, iTunes, you know, you can do this, but not anymore. We'll give you this and we'll keep the rest. Yeah. It's you're letting the camel's nose inside the tent. Sooner or later, Facebook is going to say, hey, we don't need you guys. Yeah. So I think it's a reflection of the fact, but it's a fight you can't win anyway. Because you don't go to the social media space, nobody's reading you. So you need the social media companies, but they're so much bigger and more powerful than you are. Yeah. And so much more necessary for this process to work that they're going to walk away with the bulk of the spoils here. Yeah, it's a question of when, not a question of whether.
You talked about LinkedIn. We believe that LinkedIn, and it's hard to find value anywhere in here, but from a layman's perspective, we would say that you could probably find some value in LinkedIn based on the sheer fact that it has what we feel is the greatest moat around it. You might flirt with Pinterest or Twitter and decrease your usage of Facebook or go on to Instagram, another Facebook property. But once you have your resume on LinkedIn, you're likely there for a while. And they also have a more robust revenue stream. They get revenue from different sources. Is there value in LinkedIn relative to the
other platforms?
I like
LinkedIn. I, as a social media company, LinkedIn has always impressed me as a company that has a plan. Like Facebook, It's look past the number of users, saying how do we make money off our users? So whether it's the premium memberships or whether it's the ads, they've recognized very quickly that they're in a niche market. They're not going to go face to face with Facebook on the online advertising space and win, but they don't have to. Mm-hmm. There's enough money here that you can, a niche of this market is still a pretty big market. And I think LinkedIn, because it's focused, and that's, I think, the key, has been able to succeed in that market. It's easy to get distracted here by the mood of the moment. Mm-hmm. And a lot of these social media companies chase after whatever the mood of the moment is. And LinkedIn has not done that, and that's to their credit.
So the whole social media ecosystem, private valuations, which we know now, Pinterest just raised money, I think $11 billion. We see what some of the others are. Most overvalued and undervalued company in social media in your mind?
I'd say Snapchat is probably the most overvalued I can't think of a way in which they can, maybe they've got this giant plan out there, but I can't think of a way in which their particular product can lend itself to advertising. I would say Twitter has the potential to be a valuable company. So even though it might look overvalued now, it's because of the way they're managed.
Yeah.
I think if they were managed better, that 300 million plus users could be put to much better use. Mm-hmm. But Snapchat, I can't even think of a way in which you can convert those users into revenues without without undercutting the product you're selling.
Great. Thanks, Professor.
You're welcome.